First-person shooters aren't really known for their campaigns anymore, unfortunately, but that does not mean that they've never been great. In fact, some of them have been so good that they managed to make a fantastic impression from the first moments that we got to play them. What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we're going to be taking a look at and counting down 10 first-person shooters with the best opening levels, not including tutorials. We're talking levels where you actually get in the game and get started on the storyline. So let's get started. Be sure to enter the monthly $200 Amazon gift card here on the channel. It's really easy to enter. All you have to do is like the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications for a chance to win. Leave a comment why you want it with your Twitter handle, and I will pick the winner at the end of the month. Good luck. Kicking off our list at number 10 is Half-Life, and this is one of the most influential games ever made with a pretty unconventional first level. Now, Half-Life doesn't have you start with this high action shooting section or a bunch of easy target practice, but rather has you just riding the train to work. Now, going to work doesn't exactly sound like something super fun for a video game, but for whatever reason, there is just something brilliant about this opening to the game. It does a great job of immersing you into this world and actually getting you acquainted with everything in the area. And it also gave Valve a chance to show off just how good they were at world building without the assistance of actual shooting. This, to me, is the perfect way to kick off this list. At number 9, we have Wolfenstein 2, The New Colossus. This is by far an over-the-top shooter, and it was released in October of 2017, and it picked up right where Wolfenstein The New Order left off back in 2014. A little spoiler alert for you guys, the ending of the first game left your character seriously injured and confined to a wheelchair, which makes things a little difficult when your secret submarine base gets boarded by the regime, who is actually hunting you down. However, what follows is probably one of the most badass opening sequences to a shooter ever. You grab a submachine gun and you start wheeling yourself around the boat, either guns blazing or silently using stealth kills in order to eliminate the threats and make sure the rest of your crew is safe. Leave it to Wolfenstein to make wheelchairs in a first-person shooter absolutely awesome. I can still remember this level to this day, and it was such a long time ago that I played it. At number 8, GoldenEye 007. This influential first-person shooter was released all the way back in 1997 for the Nintendo 64, and it was developed by the legendary Rare Studios. While it's mainly remembered for the multiplayer aspects, the single-player campaign was a ton of fun, and it was actually very well made for the time, showing off the power of the N64 and proving that shooters had a place in the home console market. The first mission of GoldenEye 007 has you shooting your way through a very, very heavily armed enemy base on a dam. Once you finally make your way through all the enemy troops, you get to the top of the dam and you do this crazy James Bond dive into the water below to continue on your mission. If you're looking for a retro playthrough, I highly suggest you go do the GoldenEye 007 campaign. At number 7, we have Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare. The shooter came out in 2007 and it helped shape the Call of Duty franchise and the first-person shooter genre as a whole following its insane popularity. The campaign was critically acclaimed for its visuals, its characters, its writing, everything, and the first mission titled Crew Expendable set the scene perfectly for what we were in for. You are part of a small squad infiltrating an enemy cargo ship in the middle of a stormy night as you attempt to recover inside information about a civil war in Russia. Following the discovery of a nuclear device on board, the ship is attacked and you have to escape before it goes down. If you've never played this, you should try it. If you really want some good visuals, go play this version on Modern Warfare Remastered. It is absolutely stunning. At number 6, we have Halo 2. Now, Halo 2's campaign is very different than that of the first game, as the sequel was much more cinematic and story-driven, and that is what established it right from the beginning. When you first start Halo 2's campaign, you are presented with a very detailed cutscene showing both the human and the Covenant reactions and responses to the events of the first game, which gives you some context of why the humans were so threatened by the Covenant, and also why the Covenant want the humans dead. You then find your base is being attacked by Covenant forces, and yes, it is time for Master Chief to gear up and do what he does best. You fight through hordes of Covenant, dual-wielding various guns, and it all ends with the now famous cutscene of Master Chief returning a massive bomb to the Covenant cruisers. This first campaign, this first mission, just literally gets you jacked and ready and amped to play the rest of it. This thing was amazing. Cracking into the top five today, we have Half-Life 2. Now, I know I mentioned Half-Life earlier in the list, but the second game has a fantastic opening level as well, and I have to give it another shout. Half-Life 2 was released in 2004 and is widely considered one of the best first-person shooters ever made, thanks to its excellent visuals and physics, its storytelling, its characters, its gameplay, basically the total package. A lot of changes between Half-Life 1 and 2 happened, and the opening sequence of the sequel makes that very clear while still managing not just to blab exposition to you. Valve made the bold decision to not tell you what has changed between the games and instead let you figure it out for yourself while exploring the game's world, and that, to me, was an excellent choice. The Half-Life series, especially Half-Life 2, is a great example of show, don't tell in video games. At number 4, we have Doom 2016. This reboot took a pretty big risk by returning to the roots of the FPS genre and abandoning many mechanics that are associated with it today, such as sprinting, reloading, linear levels, cutscenes, and much, much more. From the very beginning, it established that Doom isn't going to be your typical first-person shooter experience, as Doom Guy busts out of his containment, crushes a few demons, and even smashes a monitor that starts spouting exposition at him. The developers have stated in interviews that this opening sequence was their way of sticking to Doom's roots, as it's always been a gameplay-first kind of series, and they absolutely nailed it if you ask me. Now, Doom 2016, to me, is one of the best first-person shooters to come out in years, and the beginning is absolutely perfect, and I've played a little bit of this, but I'm kind of wanting to do an entire Let's Play on this channel. Let me know if you guys would like to see that. At number 3, we have Bioshock, and Bioshock is obviously one of the creepiest and most original games to come out in a very, very long time, and you know what you're getting into almost immediately thanks to the opening level, which is titled Welcome to Rapture. In this game, you play as a man who crash lands in a strange underwater city called Rapture, and it's very clear by there's been some horrific events in the past there, and then it's up to you to figure out what is going on and escape while you still want to keep yourself in one piece, which isn't that easy. The opening level of Bioshock does a fantastic job of establishing who we are, where we are, and also shows off the unique art style and sound design that the game is so well known for. It was a great, great opening level. At number 2, we have Metroid Prime. What do you think about it? Nintendo was really taking a risk with Metroid Prime. Up until this point, Metroid had been a 2D action platformer. Many people were skeptical when it was revealed that Prime was going to shift the perspective to first person, and many were afraid that the franchise would become just another Halo wannabe. There was really a lot riding on the game's success, and Nintendo blew us away with the result. Metroid Prime sets everything up for the first level perfectly as you land on a mysterious planet as Samus Aran, and the camera warps into her helmet and you start moving around in first person with various pop-ups on your HUD, sending you the messages, all that good stuff. Metroid Prime managed to keep the exploration-heavy gameplay of the previous games while moving it into a first-person perspective with even more action and combat. Everything you could want from Metroid is in Prime, and the boss fight at the end of the game's first level is honestly one of the best in the entire series. And finally, there was no doubt in my mind when this video was being made what was going to be number one. Halo Combat Evolved. Halo had a ton to prove when it was released, as the success of Microsoft's new Xbox console was pretty much hinging on whether or not this game was good. Thankfully, the game was an absolute gem. It was a masterpiece, and Halo Combat Evolved is still regarded as one of the best shooters ever made. So, the game starts with us taking control of the Master Chief, obviously a tall, beefy, faceless protagonist, paired up with the Cortana, our helpful AI partner with attitude. Shortly after the intros, the Pillar of Autumn is attacked, and it is up to us to defend it long enough for everybody to escape. We are introduced to the Covenant as we get ourselves acquainted with the guns and the gameplay, all while saving as many fellow Marines as we can and following Cortana's orders. The opening minutes of Halo Combat Evolved instantly will get you hyped for the rest of the story. It's still one of the best levels in the franchise's history, and it does the same thing that Halo 2's opening level did. It just jacks you up and amps you up for the rest of the mission. To me, hands down, Halo Combat Evolved opening mission is the best of all time. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 of the best opening levels in first-person shooters, and they are super important because they set the tone and the pace for the entire video game. So let me know where we got it right. Let me know where we got it wrong. What should have been some other levels that made it on this list? And as always, guys, if you enjoy these top 10s, make sure you turn on your notifications, check that little box, ring that bell, and make sure you're subscribed on the way out. I hope you guys have a fantastic night. I'll see you tomorrow night for a brand new one.